Should defense be rewarded in the UFC? What's up, guys? In this video, we're going to be having a complex discussion about, obviously, the recent Jose Aldo versus Mario Bautista controversial decision. But this video is not cope about that particular fight. It's just a conversation about the topic and some of the discussions that I've seen from the fan base on social media, some of the disappointment from fans about the scoring of that fight. I'm going to discuss that in this video, with the main topic being, should defense be rewarded in the UFC? And towards the middle end of this video, I will give my opinion on this topic and what I think is right. So do keep in mind, when I do discuss this topic, I will be talking about both sides. And when I say things, it's not necessarily how I feel about it. That will be located in a particular part of this video, which you guys can see in the chapters where I discuss how I feel about it. Also, this video is not about rearranging the whole scoring system. That's a separate discussion. That's another interesting discussion. Should we do open scoring? Should we do this? Should we do that? That's not what this video is about. I also do want to acknowledge that the scoring system is kind of complex. I'm still learning it. I'm not like a genius as far as the scoring system, so I don't want to act like I am. But I understand kind of the basic stuff about it. And I do understand that defense is not really scored, right? So let's get right into this, right? The main criteria of how the judges do score these UFC fights is effective striking and effective grappling, with an emphasis on damage, right? Damage trumps all. Now, this means that effective head movement isn't directly scored. So when the judges see a fighter slip a bunch of shots, that's not really significant in the scoring. Takedown defense isn't directly scored either. So when someone stuffs a takedown, the judges don't see it and say, oh, that was really good by them. The focus is on who is trying to finish the fight. That's like the main premise of the scoring, right? Effective striking and effective grappling. Dominance. As MMA is an offensive-based sport, dominance of a round can be seen in striking when the losing fighter is forced to continually defend. With no counters or reaction taken when openings present themselves, dominance in the grappling phase can be seen by fighters taking dominant positions in the fight and utilizing those positions to attempt fight-ending submissions or attacks. Merely holding a dominant position shall not be a primary factor in assessing dominance. What the fighter does with those positions is what must be assessed. So let's get right into the recent Jose Aldo versus Mario Bautista controversial example that went down at UFC 307. Fans were very frustrated with the decision. I've seen a lot of comments about Mario Bautista's performance, saying he won by not fighting, right? Saying this is the most annoying fighting style. Just a lot of criticism aimed towards Mario Bautista. Now, it was 1-1 going into round three on the judges' scorecards, and Bautista wins round three mainly by holding Jose Aldo up against the cage. So as far as the questions, right? The questions going into this discussion. Why isn't takedown defense counted in scoring? Should slips and head movement be scored? Defensive striking, right? Could effective defense be incorporated while maintaining entertainment value? That's a very, very important question, because I do think entertainment value is very important. Some people think entertainment value doesn't matter, right? I disagree. I do think it's obviously a business. It's obviously a company. You're trying to grow this. You're also trying to grow the sport as well. They're trying to make as much money as possible. And just as far as being a fan, I do like to be entertained. That doesn't mean I don't like grappling and I don't like certain aspects of fighting. But maintaining the entertainment value is very important. Could incorporating effective defense, takedown defense, defensive striking, could that be incorporated while maintaining the entertainment value, right? I also want to say this video is not cope about the Jose Aldo versus Mario Bautista fight. I'm just addressing this whole discussion. I have to clarify that. And this is not that strikers don't have their advantages. I'm not trying to make an argument for strikers or anything. Damage is scored. Damage is the main focal point of the scoring, the main premise of the scoring, right? That is an advantage for strikers, in my opinion, because striking is the most damaging art. You know, striking, kickboxing, these are some of the most Muay Thai, some of the most dangerous martial arts. They cut you. And so I do think strikers have their advantages. Takedowns are also insignificant in the scoring without something, right? You have to establish an attack, right? Takedowns can be insignificant when it comes to scoring fights. Cage control is the last thing, right? Cage control is not significant in scoring. That means holding someone up against the cage is not considered significant when you're judging a round. And every round starts on the feet. These are some of the things that do benefit strikers when it comes to scoring a UFC fight. Now let's get into the argument that defense shouldn't be scored, right? Obviously, this video is about should it be scored? Let's get into why it shouldn't. Then I'll get into the argument why it should be. So as far as the argument why it shouldn't be scored, sports overall don't reward defense without offense. This could also inspire fighters to fight safe and avoid fighting, right? Defending takedowns isn't doing damage, which is the primary aspect of scoring, which I do like. As far as interjecting with my personal opinion, I do like that there is a focus on damage in the scoring. I think it maintains entertainment value for the fans. It also grows the sport. It's just awesome. I like the focal point of damage, right? Damage, it's a fight at the end of the day. And defending takedowns, although it looks good, it isn't doing any damage technically. It is preventing damage. Like defense, this is my last point. Defense is a reward in itself, right? For example, if you stuffed a takedown, that's the reward that you're going to get. It's not going to be on the scorecards, but what it's going to be is, oh, I stayed on my feet. If you're a striker and you defend a takedown, that is your reward. Or if you dodge a big shot, right? That is your reward right there. So they already have a reward. It's already impactful in a fight. That's the argument that defense should not be scored by the judges. Now let's get into the argument that defense should be scored by the judges. So here's a basic thing, and we'll see if you guys understand this or agree with this. The objective of a wrestler is to take the opponent down. If they fail, they should be penalized for that. The other fighter won the exchange, right? So that's very interesting. I also think it's terrible optics inspiring hate from fans towards fighters such as Mario Bautista for his most recent performance against Aldo, Mirab Dwalishvili against Piotr Jan, against Jose Aldo as well. Just heavy takedown attempts, but not landing many of the takedowns at all. Kamaru Usman, in many of his fights of his career, got a lot of criticism from fans for not really getting a lot of takedowns, more holding people up against the cage, failing a lot of takedowns, but still winning decisions, right? This also would prevent shot spamming, I think, because if there is some negative scoring based on your failed takedown attempts, fighters would be hesitant to just shoot a bunch of takedowns and really overload the system, which would prevent a fighting style that a lot of fans really hate. In my examples, Mario Bautista, a lot of people hate the fighting style that he showcased against Jose Aldo, and Mirab. A lot of people hate Mirab Dwalishvili's fighting style. A lot of high output takedowns, a lot of failed takedowns. And that's not criticism for me or anything like that. I'm just talking overall about both sides of this. As far as integrating takedown defense specifically into the scoring, I saw this tweet by this guy named Andy Hickey, and he was discussing post UFC 307 Jose Aldo and the takedown defense that he showcased. This guy says, in my opinion, takedown defense should be introduced as a scoring tool under the effective grappling criteria to combat the wall install tactics in MMA, a fighting style that a lot of people hate. How do you guys feel about that tweet? And do you think takedown defense can fall under the effective grappling criteria, which is obviously very important for scoring? Again, the most important aspect of this scoring is effective striking and effective grappling, but it's mainly on a damage premise, right? It's about damage. And that's the thing where it's like, does takedown defense fit into effective grappling if it's not damage or it's not motivated by trying to finish the fight? That's what the scoring rewards. In its nature, right? Trying to push to finish the fight is what the scoring loves best, or what it's supposed to love best. I know a lot of people think the judges don't even stick to their own criteria, which is a different conversation. I think it comes down to how humans react to fighting, right? This is a very interesting conversation as well. A little bit of my opinion here. I do think scoring should incorporate the reaction from the average person. I know that's kind of confusing. I don't necessarily know if I worded that correctly, but let me put it this way. Who won the fight? I think as anyone can watch a fight and kind of give their opinion, who won that fight, right? Street fights. You can watch a street fight on Twitter and just say, oh, this guy won. Anyone can do that. Is that the same as judging? That's a conversation there, right? But as viewers, when we watch someone stuff takedowns, we just think that that's good when it doesn't count as anything by the judges. So that's kind of weird there. Here's an example, Makhachev versus Volkanovski, round 5. I think this leads to fans not understanding the complexity of the damage system, right? I remember when Alexander Volkanovski stuffed that takedown against Islam and just a lot of fans went crazy. I feel like because Makhachev's such a good grappler, such a good wrestler, the fact that Volk was able to stuff takedowns, felt like it was such a big deal, not just for the reason that it was like, oh, he still has a chance to knock him out, he's on the feet. It felt like it was going to weigh in the scoring. It felt like it was a really good look for Volkanovski. How do you guys feel about that? Now, I know everyone agrees he won round five, and I know that a lot of people think he lost that fight anyway. I'm not saying Volk won the fight, but I am saying that I do feel like just a lot of average fans, you can call them casuals, whatever you want to call them, thought Volk won that fight. Part of the reason was because he did have some success defending takedowns when defense is not rewarded in the scoring. Him stuffing a takedown against Makhachev doesn't mean much. The only reward he would get from that would not be on the scoring. It would be that he gets to stay on the feet in the actual fight, right? You guys understand that? It also kind of leads to, I'm talking about the average person viewing a fight, right? Is no system the best way to score a fight? Simply, who won the fight? That's very interesting. I wonder if there was no complex system, heavily predicated on damage or heavily predicated on this or that or effective striking, effective grappling. What if no system is the best way to score? You just watch a fight and say, all right, who won that fight? Kind of an interesting conversation there, or who won that round, and then you just tally all the rounds on the 10-9 system, whatever system you want to use for scoring, but is no criteria the best way, right? No criteria, no certain things weigh heavier. It's just you watch it and you think who won that round, and then obviously who won that fight. So I also want to talk about this. This will be my opinion on this subject. I think showcasing the art of defending a takedown can be very important to a fight. I think it's very impressive. And I also think that Jose Aldo stuffing 10 takedowns from Mario Bautista feels like it should be worth something, right? It doesn't feel like, oh, nothing happened there, nothing significant happened there. Like, again, it kind of leads to the point of when you're watching the fight, for example, Jose Aldo versus Mario Bautista, it's not like, oh, Jose Aldo stuffed a takedown, he gets to stay on the feet, he has a chance to knock him out here, that was nice, he was able to stuff that takedown. It feels like, oh, he stuffed the takedown, that's good for Aldo. Or it feels like it should weigh in the scoring, right? Sometimes when we're watching it, but it just doesn't, right? The reward that he gets is staying on his feet. Same with head movement, distance management. It just sometimes feels like it should be credited in scoring if it is substantial to the fight, right? A lot of fighters who weaponize their head movement or their defensive abilities to be able to dodge big shots, it feels like that could be credited in scoring if it is substantial to the fight, but obviously the judging criteria does not really score that unless you're doing damage after it, right? They don't care about if you slip a shot. They care about if you slip a shot and land your own shot because you won that exchange. You're coming closer to finishing the fight. Heavy focus on damage, which I do like as a fan. So I will say that they shouldn't reward effective defense. That's my opinion. I don't think they should reward it. If you guys want to hear some of the reasons why, I do kind of agree with the argument that I talked about earlier. I do think there's a lot of good points in there. But I will say, I honestly, sometimes fights do feel weird, and it feels like many fans do count this aspect when it doesn't apply to actual scoring. I know the fans don't matter, it's the judges that actually do matter, but the fans' scoring does kind of matter because sometimes the judges will, you know, say, oh, this guy won the fight, and everyone's like, what? That doesn't make any sense. But sometimes, based on their scoring, it actually does make sense, which leads to a lot of criticism for fighters, a lot of backlash against the UFC, and just a lot of overall problems, right? And sometimes these fights do feel weird, right? When you see a guy like Jose Aldo stuff a bunch of takedowns and it just doesn't mean much, right? Aldo losing two decisions due to being controlled against the cage, mainly in these fights, if you do watch these fights, very damaging career losses as well. Let's talk about Jose Aldo here. Versus Mauro Bautista really in 2022, if he would have won this fight, he would have fought for the title. He ends up retiring after this fight for a brief period, but Mauro was 0-16 on takedowns. He does win this fight by decision. Against Mario Bautista, Bautista went 0-10 on takedowns in that fight. It just feels like Aldo should be rewarded for that, right? But you're not rewarded for that other than if you do your own damage. And your reward is staying on the feet, which I do understand because the focal point is damage, right? And you don't want to prioritize fighters fighting really defensively. You want to prioritize doing more damage, coming closer to finishing the fight. So I do kind of agree with the argument that stuffing a takedown or dodging a big punch, that is your reward for defense. It's just sometimes it does feel weird, and sometimes it feels like we do gotta give some credit, give some respect to the art of takedown defense, because it's an art itself, and it's very impressive from Jose Aldo. It feels like we have to honor that, right? Man, Jose Aldo's takedown defense percentage is so good that we gotta praise that. But should we, right? Judges likely see Bautista being the only one doing anything when it comes to the scoring, right? Aldo's lack of striking output while being held up against the cage is why he lost round three. But should it be this way when he successfully defended four takedowns in that round and Bautista lacked damage as well? Bautista did not showcase effective grappling, so how did he win? Now, I know a lot of people think Bautista did win that fight. I know a lot of people think that Jose Aldo won the fight. I know a lot of people think Aldo won rounds one and two. Some people may think Aldo won all rounds. I know round one's kind of the controversial round when it comes to the scoring, not really round three. But round three was the deciding round for the judges. So that's why I'm talking about that round in particular. And Aldo did successfully defend four takedowns. Keyword successfully. I do think that is success for Aldo. But based on the scoring criteria, it's no damage. But we didn't see much damage from Bautista either, so it's kind of a lackluster round, very difficult to score in that way. But I guess Bautista was the guy with the cage control, right? That's the last thing of the scoring. It's very complex there, but should Jose Aldo's takedown defense even be praised by the fans when it just means nothing? It doesn't really mean anything. He's got like a 92% career takedown defense, but it just doesn't mean much when it comes to scoring fights. And I do feel like this is a problem for Jose Aldo. And maybe he doesn't understand the current scoring, right? That there is a focus on damage. Because sometimes when he's in these positions, I think he thinks of the fight optically, right? Like, oh, I'm stuffing all these takedowns. He's just holding me up against the cage. I'm going to win. But the judge's criteria does not reward that style of fighting. You got to do damage in those positions, which I do like. But it can be annoying and it can be confusing as well. And it doesn't prevent shot spamming and it doesn't prevent holding someone up against the cage, right? Is this a different topic where it's about the refs and having to break those positions up if they're failing a bunch of takedowns? I don't really know. But I mean, when you think about Dan Hooker versus Gamrot, when Gamrot's failing takedowns, Dan Hooker's doing damage in those positions, which is why he ended up winning that fight, right? Landing elbows and things like that. Jose Aldo does not take advantage when it comes to doing damage, and it has negatively affected his career. In that fight versus Murat Abolishvili, where he did defend takedowns, he just lacked the damage, and you're not going to win just by defending. And that's what this topic is about. Do you think he should be given wins by successfully defending 16 takedowns from a very good wrestler in Marab, or 10 takedowns from a good wrestler in Bautista? Should that be rewarded in the scoring? What are your guys' opinion on this topic? I gave my opinion, but I do think this is a very interesting conversation, although it may be a basic answer like no, right? But I do think some people may feel like yes, because sometimes when you watch it, it just feels like something is there for Aldo, and it feels like his 92% takedown defense should have a bigger reward other than he just gets to stay on the feet. You know what I mean? It feels a little bit anticlimactic, or maybe that's just a stat we got to ignore and it's not too important when it comes to scoring. Just important when it comes to, oh, he's matching up against a wrestler, he's going to have his chances to knock him out. So again, what do you guys think? Leave your opinions in the comments below. Other than that, if you guys would like this video and subscribe for more UFC conversations, obviously, I appreciate it massively. Thank you, and thanks for watching this video.